line of demarcation in the Cold War lies in Berlin. West Berlin, with its burgeoning prosperity, is a thorn in the side of the Reds. Refugees from the East escaped by the tens of thousands until the communists in desperation threw up their wall of hate to seal off the border. In a decade, more than 4 million East Germans fled their homes, causing a drain on communist Germany's economy that was called no longer tolerable. Their answer, the wall. Now entire families are separated, their only communication a wave from a distance. This is heartbreak. This is the poignant drama not found in the reports of diplomats. A bride in the East can only wave to her mother in the West. She takes her vows in public loneliness. The border is strengthened, but still they escape. She hangs from a second-story window. The Red police try to pull her back. The Westerners try to free their grip. East Germans grasp any fleeting chance. A guard's back is turned, the barbed wire is slashed, and Westerners stretch forth willing hands to pull them to asylum. They gamble that a sudden rifle shot won't end their dreams, that a slip won't bring disaster. Freedom is man's most prized possession, and it is only for those who love it.
Shame in Berlin was 1 year old. It was in 1961 that East German communists, appalled at the numbers who were fleeing to the West, threw up the wall. It separated families, but unwittingly the Reds united Germany as never before since World War II.